Hello and welcome to the episode 103 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Some of the stories I will tell you today include two Hamburg residencies, the Beatles' debut on BBC and the recording of John Lennon's first serious song. On the 30th of April 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, played the top 10 club in Hamburg, West Germany, for their ongoing residency there. In 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best in the lineup, started another residency in Hamburg, this time for a 7th-week engagement at the Star Club, the newest rock and roll venue in town. The band was required to play for 4 hours one night and 3 the next, alternating 1-hour-long slot with an hour of rest. For 2 of the 7 weeks, they shared the bill with Gene Vincent. In 1963, after 11 appearances on British independent television networks, broadcast locally, or on large sections of the national territory, the Beatles debuted on BBC for the 6:25 show. The programme was meant to showcase up-and-coming young talent. This particular show, aired on the 16th of April, also featured Jimmy Young, Rolf Antino, Bobby Carroll, Hank Locklin, Woods Dinwis, Johnny Pearson, and Mickey Greaves' four-piece orchestra, a classical ensemble. The recording and filming took place today at the Live Grove Studio E in London. One could tell that it was the BBC from the complexity of the schedule alone. There was a band call at 10:30 a.m., 2 camera rehearsals, one at 11:30 and one at 2:15 p.m., a 4:30 p.m. final rehearsal, and finally, a 7:30 to 8:15 p.m. taping of the show. The Beatles chose to perform From Me to You, Thank You Girl, and Please Please Me. The latter was the song closing the show, and the Beatles were joined by all the other guests for its performance. After the filming was completed, the lads attended a private party at the home of the Shadows guitarist Bruce Welch, where they met Cliff Richard for the first time. Fun fact, the Beatles were advertised to appear, without a performance, at a football club dance in Oldham, but the taping of the 6:25 show prevented them to go. In 1964, George Harrison arrived at the Twickenham Film Studios in the morning to shoot a clothing company marketing boss sequence for A Hard Day's Night. In the afternoon, he was joined by John Lennon to shoot the bathroom scene. Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr were enjoying a day of rest and were not around. The set was visited by Roy Orbison, who happened to be in Britain and wanted to reconnect with the Beatles. On the 13th of April 1965, the Beatles were again busy with Professor Foote's cadenza scene at the Twickenham Film Studios for their 2nd feature film, finally known as Help, from today onwards. The band wasn't needed anymore in the afternoon, but they remained on location to record a brief interview for BBC Radio's Pop In, broadcast between 1 and 1:55 p.m. on the day. The Beatles were featured shortly after 1:45 p.m. BBC had hoped for another bank holiday special, one that would have departed from the formula of their previous 4 From Us to You offerings, but the band was simply too busy with the film and generally overworked to even consider that idea. Manager Brian Epstein then had to placate the top hats on the board with this interview. The main reason for choosing Help as the film title was that John Lennon had liked it so much that he had written a song with that name. Today, between 7 and 11:15 p.m, the Beatles recorded 8 takes of the rhythm track plus 4 takes of overdubs at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. By the end of the session, the song featured bass, drums, an acoustic 12-string guitar, 2 electric guitars, John's double-tracked vocals, tambourine, and backing vocals by Paul McCartney and George Harrison. Lennon later pointed at this song as his first real message number, a serious piece of work opposed to the manieristic efforts that he had produced in the early part of his songwriting career. Finally, in 1966, we have another recording session, this time for the Beatles' Revolver album. Working as ever at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road, the band completed George Harrison's Granny Smith, later renamed Love You Too, recording some overdubs onto it, including a vocal harmony by Paul McCartney that was not included in the final mix. The tentative mono mixes of the songs wrapped up the 2:30 to 6:30 p.m. session. Then, between 8 p.m. and 2:30 a.m., the Beatles worked on their next single, Paperback Writer. In the allotted time, they managed to record two takes of the rhythm track, the first of which was interrupted, fixing the song's structure. Ringo played drums, John played tambourine, George played the rhythm part on his Gibson SG guitar, and Paul supplied a lead guitar part on his Epiphone Casino. And this second recording session leads us to the conclusion of yet another episode of this podcast. If you like what you're hearing, if you have any suggestion or constructive criticism, please drop me a line. In addition, in the episode description, you will find a link to the support page of my website, www.simonmas.com/support, which you can refer to should you want to lend a hand and show me how fab you are. Help me out here and make sure that I will keep on posting other music-related content for you to enjoy. Tomorrow, we will have proof that the Get Back project wasn't the end of the Beatles. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.